I'm going to figure out what that door is. Excuse me. I am like choking up here. Okay, second to last house for today is my finger is cramping up. There we go. Hydra Septivox. What a name. Septivox. This one, I don't know. I just like the variety of it. There's a lot going on here. Even though they're using very few items to pull it off, you can see they have gone absolutely bonkers with the stepping stones that you get from Starcom Basin. For most of their landscaping, they built a lot of, I don't know, it's a stony build, and they've got like rivers going through it. The little hill here is, I don't think it's mostly the stepping stone. I think it's just the gray stones, but it's a really fun little thing they did. I mean, just think of how many pieces that they got here. So we're just gonna run around the outer edge here using the overgrowth to kind of give it a little greenery. They've got snow bits even in combo with the green grass. They got a little bit of snow. So it's again, it's a little strange combination, but I think it's pretty. Again, when you work with the waterfalls and stuff, it's not always necessary to give like a realistic reason as to where the water's coming from. It's just literally pouring out of the rocks. You don't have to build a special little cave or anything like that. Because in the kind of world that we, are playing in, it's basically anything goes. So you don't have to get too accurate. When you do, then you better be sure that you do it really well because we'll be picking at it. Now, this looked like it might have been a little hidey hole or something, but obviously I'm too fat to get in there. But that'd be a good hiding place for a little treasure or Easter egg or something like that. So again, lots and lots of stones. They did a good job of not making it too uniform. They've turned it, resized it, altered the elevations and stuff, so it's not very samey. That's real key in being a good landscaper, which I am not. But again, got little hints of snow. There's a little bit of frozen lake to kind of, account for the coldness, and yet it's raining, so that, yeah, it's kind of a weird combo. A little bit of the, I guess, the glacier pillars for some of this. I think that's even the small snowy platform there. And then as you go around, you get more into the green. So you have the little mossy covered head. The stepping stones were good in helping them to add some depth to their river, by the way. A lot of people build it straight on the surface of the ground, and then later they go, man, I wish I'd given that a little bit of a lift there. But this is a good way, and it really lends itself well to that curviness. So you don't have to worry about too many of the gaps and stuff. You just kind of let the rocks kind of fill in where they need to be. And since there's so many rocks, it's a lot easier to follow the contour of the river. Again, see, they just kind of let it drop off. And they're really not, explaining where does it go. Just says, oh, it just goes right off the edge. And that's okay. See, this is more the green. There's like tall grass and the thorny bushes and the bulberry bushes. I don't know what they're called. Some kind of bushes. Got the hot springs over here. So you have like two different seasons going on here. You got the winter side and the springy side. Here's that massive umbrella tree that most people don't use as is. You always see it upside down, but there it is, and it's pretty grand glory there. We're back at the start now, so I'm just going to kind of note how they did the platform. They've just taken an oversized rock. Now, I've tried this myself, and I don't know how they're doing it. I can't get it to work for me, but apparently these the gray tier stones and the sandstone version is hollow inside, and usually anything hollow, as long as you size it big enough and position it just right, you can get it to cover the platform. And you can see clearly that they've been able to do that, but I haven't. I like how they've made this little cave thing where the where if you die, this is where it is. But look, they put the new little tea set. They hid the best part, the little oren on the other side. They got this little cave thing going on. And I think these are some of the, I really don't, I assume it's some of the engine parts. Those blue, and they've just made it look like little glowworms in this little cave. And boop, there you are. See, I didn't even notice that when I come around the first time. But there it is. You can see the little glowworm showing. But like here, they've repeated the rock and made this nice smooth staircase. Again, it's always good to kind of test it out with your character when you're making these staircases to make sure it feels pretty good. Like I'm kind of regret how I did mine on my main plot because the steps are so steep. Your camera just kind of goes chunk, chunk, chunk as you go up, and this is a lot smoother in that regard. But I'm too lazy to change it now, so you just have to suffer with the messy bit. The bridge is just a rope bridge, and they've added these, I think it's called the fiercely glowing column for the ends to kind of finish it off so it doesn't look like it's just hanging in midair. Now there is a different kind of rope bridge. I think it's called Brooke's bridge. It already comes with the little end pieces, and it's a lot more elaborate and very rare. So if you do happen to see it, it'll probably cost you a pretty penny. Yeah, that's true too. Let me see. Wait, it's just he bounces really funny. Don't you think? Well, really, for most plots, you're not going to want to be on your hoverboard anyway, unless it's, you know, a hoverboard track, and then I think that's kind of beside the point anyway, so. But yeah, that's kind of funny. So this little mountain hill kind of thing that they've got going on. We were talking about fab kits and how people have found ways to integrate them into their plot theme, and this is a good example. This is the mining fab kit, and they've just enclosed it in this pile of stones. They've added crystals to kind of coincide with what you can get here. I guess is that mining? Is that that's mining? Isn't it? It's not the the relic one. Yeah, it's mining. So this is one of those instances where they've found a way to kind of hide it. So it doesn't look all clunky looking like it normally would, and they've just built around it and made it a natural looking feature, but giving you access to it for those that want it. So that's again, it's a nice way. Same way with here, with the garden fab kit. They've boxed it in with glass, made some pretty designs, which we'll look at a little closer here in a second. I'm just coming up to the top here to look at this little floaty thing. This reminds me of the plot we looked at before. Now, I walked at it from the snowy slope, but you can also get to it from over here. They have a nice little staircase built. It's all stones. So you can imagine how many stones that took to make that nice, lovely, smooth staircase. And just all the stones built for this little mountain hill kind of thing. So, yeah, you can imagine they've used up a lot of the decor count on this. And this is all above the actual prefab home. They're using Draken pillars for the supports of this little structure up here. Granite fencing for the railing. Lots of overgrowth to kind of give it that little mossy look. As you know, it's a wet plot with all the rain and everything. And then, from what I can tell, it is bowls. And the metal plates, I think, could be the bowl as well. It's hard to tell with the shape of it, but it's just layered bowls to make the stairs and the actual main form of this little. It's not quite a gazebo, but it's a little garden area, and they've just interlaid the other ones to give it a little decoration. It's really pretty. Trying to see if you can see it better from below. You can see they've kind of hidden part of it with stones on the sides, a little bit covered up with overgrowth, so you can't see it all. But I'm pretty sure those are bowls, just because of the shape of it. It could be something else, maybe it's something else, but I'm pretty sure it's bowls. Excuse me, I love the way they've done the little rosy filled vines above. It's just the cerulean sky growths. They've just plastered a bunch of those. They've shrunk them down and stuck them from side to side all along the top pillar. And then they've put the habanero bushes in amongst that. It's a really pretty look. For someone that's looking for some nice garden elements for their lawn or plot or whatever, that's a really lovely result. I mean, even with the little blue thing showing, it doesn't detract too much. You mostly see just the green and the red. They did make a little pond here. Looks like just because of the shape of it, it looks like the rivers, the winding rivers, and then just a round circular bit of stone. These are upside down barnacle weeds. It's my favorite. It looks like chocolate. So it's like little chocolate bricks here. And then these are, I guess it's the. I'm not sure what that is. It's one of the crystals, I think, that has that really bright, sparkly effect. Soccer probably know the name because I'm pretty sure soccer's used them a lot. But it has that little sparkle effect. Just, I don't know, just a little feature here for you to look at. Again, it's all trimmed in the overgrowth, a little bit supported with stones. And then it's got trees and statues and things. Just a really cute little idea. I don't know what the little fence post here is for. Aha. I have the power. I've been infused with. It's from that fab kit there to give you the little bouncy. Ah, right. Okay, so this is our access to the up above there. Let's see. I don't know. Do you think I can make the jump? I'm a little nervous. Oh, that's way off. Now, this is going to be another one of those. I'm going to probably mess it up a lot. I'm going to try, but I make no promises in being successful. I can tell you I have made it at least once because I know it's like a little clubhouse above. I'm going to tell you that now because I have no guarantee that oh, gosh. I hate this fab kit. I so hate it. I can't even get out of the little crack there. Gosh. No. I'm just going all over the place. Oh, does it work while you're on the mount? I thought it took you off your mount. Well, that's kind of helpful to know. Oh my gosh. I don't know if that's a good idea. It may make me worse. Just fell all the way down. This is, again, I picked like the worst examples to visit today because there's too much jumping involved. My apologies. You really need a skilled person doing this. I'm trying to get like to the highest point here. I'm gonna end up hitting something. I just know it. Wow, that was so wrong. No, going all the way back. Oh gosh, I forgot about this part actually. It having this little house here. I'm afraid I'm gonna hit the bottom of that when I jump, but I'm gonna try. Honk. Oh, we made it. So yeah, don't do it like me, but you're supposed to magically appear on this little platform. Well, I used to have it. I actually used it for a beta guild that I was in. I used it as a event kind of thing. It was either that one or the Whirlwind. I can't remember which. It was one of those that had a little floaty buff. And I built a crow's nest on the top of my piglet spaceship, and I'd have them use the buff to try and jump and land in the crow's nest. And it was a silly thing, and a lot of people found ways to kind of, get it every time, but we still had those that were like me who had trouble landing in the right spot. Anyway, if you cleverly know how to get around on those things really well, you shouldn't have any trouble reaching this little clubhouse thing. I like how it's built. It's very rustic looking. You've got the tiki roof being used as the roofing. You can see the little bits, the beams of it sticking out here. They're using the little dividers. I don't know if it's the light one or the dark one. I think it's the honey one for the walls. For the entranceway, they've got the Draken like archway fence gate thingy kind of blocking it off. And that's always nervous. It always makes me nervous when I walk in here because they got that little glass floor there. But you can see how they got the dividers for all of the walls, even around the window parts. Got the chua netting acting as a hammock kind of thing. A lot of people do. But it fits really well in here. It's got that, again, it's like a little tiki hut clubhouse thing. Got nice view of down below. The bottom of the flooring is, I believe, decking pieces. They could have made the entire bit in decking, but I like that they used the dividers. You do have some little quirks about, how one end is a little broader than the other, so you have these little bits sticking out, but it really doesn't detract at all. I mean, it is just kind of a little clubhouse shack kind of thing. But it's a little cozy place. And of course, you have to have that talent to be able to make the jump. Now, instead of dying, I'm just going to pop back down. So that's where we were up there in that little bit. And then, of course, the little park thing was up above. And then you have, let me see, I want to said I was going to visit the garden here. The garden is basically just encased in glass here. And they've got it overlaid. Of course, let me see, I'll just turn that off. You can see how the glass, they've put it in nice, pretty patterns. But they even went through the trouble of adding icicles to one side because this side has kind of got the wintry part. Same way over here. I think that's just fun that they thought to include those little bits. Look, even the overgrowth on the bottom of the pillars just kind of helps dress it up. That one's kind of floating in space, though. I think that was a boo-boo. It's one of those things. But I love the staircase of the stones, but that's a lot of rock. Okay, so let's go inside, have a look. Yeah, we start off with the dining room, library kind of thing. Again, these shelves come empty and they've added all of these books and things individually, most of them. So you can see they've got a mix and matched of those. They've got this one leaning. All of that they had to do themselves. And of course, picking what items they're going to add at that new little pot of money there. All those books. It's different ones. I mean, this is a stack that probably comes like that, but the rest, that's all individually put in there. I think a lot of people that aren't familiar with housing and what comes as is, just don't even notice those kind of details. Yeah, it could be Ducky. It could be. We'll just pretend we didn't notice it, and it was perfectly placed. A lot of people don't realize what this is. This is the Dominion shelf. I think it's called the Imperium shelf when it's just in your inventory, and then it changes to Dominion shelf when it goes into your crate, or it's vice versa. It's one of the ways. A lot of people like using this as a refrigerated block. I've seen folks use it as handles for things, or countertops for like shelving and stuff. And this one, they're using it just as a like preserving special keepsakes. Some prized possessions. They've got it encased in that glass, kind of plasticky something or other. The doorway here is really nice. You've got stones lining the top just to give it a little extra something different. And then the Elden bits. I say bits because I don't know really exactly what I think it's the bottom of the statue lady. But I really couldn't say for sure. But it dresses up this entranceway really nicely, just gives us something different. And then just going with the regular old arch, it just kind of dresses it up a little bit. But I love how they've got this all. It's kind of like an Elden kitchen. They've got all this green and a little touch of Dominion. Look at this little, I guess this is the refrigerator, or maybe that is. This is, might be just a cabinet, but that's a Dominion fence post. It's just sized up and sunk down. It actually would go all the way down in there somewhere. This is the tip of it, the top. And they've used a curved glass for this part, a framed glass for the bottom to make it look like this part here is like the doors. And I don't know what they're using for the handle bit. It looks almost like the gear lamp, but in the sliding, I can't be sure. It might have changed what it looks like, but it's really nicely done. It's an interesting little cabinet, and they're using that gap in the bottom as where they put the wine. I really like that. It's a clever combination of items, you know, making something out of something else, but not adding too much. It's just the little details of where the door would be and the handles, and then you have this little thing. Again, using the holiday gift bags as little grocery bags is a good idea. Here you've got all the little fruit and cheese and wine that they've got in there. All of these bottles and dishes, they put them all in themselves. The countertop here, I believe, is upside down gear trophies to get that nice pearly white. And then the bottom is just sealed off with travel posters. The travel posters are used extensively over here for the countertop and oven top as well. The bits that they're using for the actual oven bit of the little stovetop thingies, I don't know what they're called. I'm really not sure what those are. It looks like it might be the bottom of the vent tank, but I'm pretty sure that can be perfectly round, and these look more kind of squarish. So I don't know what they're using for it. It could be the bottom of this, for all I know, and they just happen to have extras and decided to use that. This is that ever famous sink that disappeared for a while. It is now available again from the Boxing Gym Fab Kit, but you do have to complete it, I believe. Complete that challenge before you can actually get a chance to get it. So they're still relatively expensive. I think the last time I checked, they were around the plat. Around 1 to 2 plat. Before, when it kind of went vamoose for a little bit, I think it was up to 50. So it's come down pretty drastically, but you can get it from the Boxing Gym Fab Kit if you can find one that's working and everything. I think the bottom is being covered up by a Dominion bookshelf, but I'm not for positive on that. The back wall, the honeycomb part, I'm pretty sure that's a card table. You know, it's like a big green, it kind of almost looks like a half moon shape. I think that's what that is. It's a really pretty little way of, again, dressing up the kitchen nicely. They've got the, looks like the, let's see up here, those fancy hanging lights. They've just inset it. And then I don't know what they're using for this little curved part here, but making it look like a little, kind of like a chandelier for their kitchen. It's a really cute way. Just glass, framed glass panels for the shelves. Trying to note up anything else. I don't know what this is called. I know it's Dominion specific, but I don't remember what it was. I guess this is supposed to be the fridge, maybe. Like that's a little cooling, like do-do-do, you put in the amounts or something. Again, when you get into these little details, sometimes the camera distance is a big factor. It's kind of like with the egg hunt. I warned my guildies that the eggs were fairly small, so that they might have to kind of zoom in, but I think a lot of people will be surprised that they can't just see the eggs from a distance. They have to actually move the camera in quite a ways to be able to notice it, because you lose those little details. Dominion generator. Yeah, that might be it. Okay, so that's most of this floor. So let's go up this little spiral staircase. These are just 2x4s. They're just floating. There's no centerpiece or anything. The railing is one of the string lights from Shades Eve. Now, if you're wondering about these, I do believe those are just part of the prefab home. You can change the look of the corner pieces. I think that's not. I don't think that's anything someone's actually using. It just comes that way. This is an interesting little combination of items. It's like a decorative, I don't know what that's supposed to be. If I could get it to quit turning green there. You'll see it's one of those marauder displays with just a good many of those purple crystal formations smooshed in there. You know, it's mostly, I think, designed to kind of bring out the colors that they've chosen for the furniture and the decorations here. The little angel piece, I think that's one of the Dominion emblems or something. Excuse me. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's part of the house, these little bracket bits here. They're really nifty. It would be nice if we could have some of those parts so that we could use them. Be pretty cool, but that gives you an idea. If you don't like these or you want some in, you know, a house that doesn't have those, some of the fence posts and stuff might could work like that. I mean, like the if you want a Draken version, you could probably use a Draken training pole for that. That has some nice little spiky bits and, you know, pole form. Kind of make it look a little interesting. This pink stuff is some of the technophage bits. I don't know if those are multiple pieces to get that bracket over and over, but I suspect so, but I'm not for positive. They've boxed it in a little bit with the Cassian pillars. Over here we have an inset little shelf, just 2x4s, and then just an assortment of books and little keepsakes. The stairs also 2x4s, and then more of the, I think it's the technophage trim circuitry thing for that. That's the technophage platform. That's the emitter over here. That's the thing I say it looks like a gas pump. And that's the Core Y83 portal thingy. You don't want to click on that. So this is like a little game room. But look at the just overlapping here of the bits. I have no idea what all that is. It looks like a triangle piece, maybe some overlapping glass. That looks like one of the Aura nightlights in the center there. Just to give an interesting little design and keeping with the color scheme of the purple and the pink. It's just a really strange little combination of stuff. The little shelf here, that's a Dominion bench that they're using. And then just backing it with posters to kind of give it some little bits. But yeah, I don't have any idea what all that is back there. Other than the pieces that I named, it might be framed glass. It's got some of that design going. I don't know what this part is here. Little shape. It does not come to mind very, you know, right off the top of my head. Well, I like it to an extent. I like how it's been used here. Generally, usually when I see the Technoface stuff, it's always in a disco bar kind of thing, and you see that so much, you just don't want to do something like that. But this is a really different approach to using it to color a room. And I really like how they, I'll get stuck in the door. I really like how they've done it. It's not too much, but it's just enough pieces that it looks nice. Even the windows are really lovely how they're done. It's just a simple, I mean, it's just bunch of squares put together, but you know, a lot of people don't take the time to just add that extra little bit surrounded by Cassian pillars. It's a really cute little place. Whoops, just fell right off the stairs there. Again, I don't know what that is per se. It looks like that Elden lady thing, but I don't know what it is. See, I think that's the little glowy thing that she's holding or something. Off to the next floor. Notice they make sure that it's all trimmed up. They really went out of their way to make all these little dressings for the archways and all the doors. That means we got about an hour left, I think, because I think they're shutting down for, oops, shutting down for maintenance soon. Yeah, Ducky, just do the daily on every single one of your characters and you'll be fine. So here we have an interesting use. Notice they've changed the walls here. It's stony, and it kind of camouflages this. Obviously, if you mouse over it, lights up. But this is that new stone door from the Taurine dungeon chase event. It's a really fun way of using it indoors. And then, ta-da, now you've got it all kind of red and orange. Again, some really interesting combinations of items and placement. You have the emblem up above, just to kind of accent the ceiling there. You've got the Marauder face. It's actually the Marauder emblem, but they've got it sunk down so that you just see the skull and the eye. The desk is just like a multitude of travel posters. You can see they've got it covered up on the inside, but look how many it took for this part here, the backing. There's a lot there. Again, the shelves, 2x4s. I want to say the blackboard is also a poster, but it looks a little darker, so it might be a maintenance platform for that. Or something else. It could be something else. I really don't know. Looks like maintenance platform because I can kind of see the blue trim there. Because it's a little bit darker than the posters. Over here we have a nice little dresser cabinet set. I think these are all different posters, and just depending on how the light hits it, it looks a little different. I could be wrong. It could be something else for the inset part, but I'm pretty sure the divider bits are also posters, and of course, the outside is posters as well. But like, I'm not sure what all this is. I think that's one of those, the red Elden tubes. And then they've got posters stacked up and kind of shrunk down to make it almost looks like an old-fashioned camera, accordion camera looking thing. And then they've got the new Elden control panel stuck on front. And it's just kind of boxed in and finished off with casting pillars. And then they got that the poster stacked up again here just to make it look a little different. This little encasement here with the plants, this little what do you call it, terrarium kind of thing. Again, there's posters in the bottom to make the little triangle shape. A little bit sticking out there. Some grass, stones, shrunken trees. Yeah, Technotube, that's the name. The lighter part. What lighter part? I don't know what you mean, Ducky. Yeah, it could be trophy. I thought about that, but it looks a little too dark. But again, it could be the lighting that's just causing it. The only reason I wasn't sure was because it's hard to see if there's a seam. So I'm pretty sure they can't get this one whole piece here as one trophy. It's really hard to, there might be a seam here, maybe. So it could be the bottoms of the trophies. It's very possible. I know they're using the posters for sure, but the other part, I'm not quite for positive. The only reason I suspected it might also be posters, and it's just the reflection is a little different, is because over here, if you get and change the lighting, it lightens up quite a bit. That's the only reason I suspected it might be different, but I don't know. It's a really nice use of items for sure. But yeah, you can kind of see a seam there as well. But see, that also might be just one poster back, for all I know. I don't know. Well, it could be. Let me see. Yeah, see, it might be the trophies, because is that the trophy top sticking out? Because they have that little bit of a gold gear on there. I suspect this with it. See, here it's used again. Looks like trophies. That's probably what it is on the other side as well. The lighting in here is a little better. Because I'm pretty sure that's the top part where the trophy bit is, isn't it? But I love how they've kept with color schemes. I'll look more in that room. I just kind of wandered in this one, so while we're in here, we'll take a look. But again, travel posters for most of it, and I'm presuming trophy bottoms for these bits here. The walls are Dominion conference tables, if I remember correctly. It's got that nice blue marble. And they're also filling it in with frozen lakes or rivers or whatever it's called to kind of keep that blue motif and theme. Blue crystals, that little round bit, I believe, is part of the Marauder digital netting up top. The sink over here, again, is poster pieces. One of the Elden bit thingies, glass for the shelves. And for the mirror, well, your guess is as good as mine. Not sure about that. I know this part, I think, is like one of the pictures, the portraits with the guy with the red eye thing. And they put something on the back. I don't know what that is. Yeah, the conference tables really look nice as the walls. And you don't have the problem that the benches do, that they don't light up or anything. They really made fun use of those tables. I don't know what this is. Something that's been enlarged and it has like some kind of a glass bit on it. I like how they're using the Elden fencing, the laser fence, as the towel rack. The little shower thing, that's a combination of a couple of those Dominion wardrobes, I think it is, and the body scanner, I think, is the big bit with the metal frames on it. And then I think they just kind of finish it off with either posters or Cassian pillars to kind of just box it off a little bit. For the tub or the jacuzzi or tank or whatever, I don't know what they're using for all the blue lighting. It's really bright and pretty though. Looks like some kind of a landing pad almost. Winding river, waterfall for that part, some of that Elden stuff. I don't know what this is. Looks like some domes, Cassian domes, but I don't know what the blue stuff is. Maybe just some of the neon signs strategically placed to get that nice strip of blue, because it looks like strips, like it's been layered in some way. And I think that's one of the Taurine shriney things. I don't know. I can't remember most of the names of this stuff. Getting really bad. Yeah, if I turn it off, it's just going to magically be like Houdini and stay up. There we go. See? Poor little towel. We'll put his rack back on there. Excuse me. That's the bathroom. Let's go back into the bedroom. We still got some things to look at there. This bit here, I think, is part of one of those wardrobes. And then you've got a travel poster. And then these bits are the magnetized containers because they're showing off that orange really a lot. And they are replaying that over here, the blue. The Dominion bed is accented with, it looks like a 2x4 for this little backing piece. And then you've got these little crystals. That's one of those new chipped saucers, little teacup saucer. And they just put a bunch of little crystals on there. That's a red lantern on top of, it looks like one of those Dominion emblem thingies. It's really nice how they managed to find a lot of items that showcase the colors that they want. The closet, again, it looks to be 2x4s, even the inside of the walls. A couple of glass panels for the sliding door kind of thing, and then just different things for hanging inside. Excuse me. But yeah, I think that's part of the wardrobe or the body scanner. It's one or the other. Wardrobe, I think, is more probably the right answer. Some really nice ideas here. Is there anything I missed? Something that you guys. Yeah, there's possibility that she can. I know she's got plans of expanding on that interactables bit, but I think she just wants to give people time to kind of play around with what she has for it now, and then from there, kind of decide where people want to go with it. I haven't even really used it myself. I don't know, I'm kind of skittish about this. Okay, last house for today. And we will be off. So we're going to take a visit to Senesh Sirkuf. Sirkauf? I don't know. I'm really horrible at names. Senesh. Sirkuf for Sukkot. It sounds Frenchy. It's called the Primaris Quadrant. As you can see, they did a good job of kind of tucking in the teleport pad. I don't know if it's a. I think it's a snowy hill upside down to give a little lift to the area here. Added in some tents, some stones, some of those new bramble bushes we got. And just kind of made it kind of like you're walking in from this little nook and cranny kind of spot. The camp itself is just, the tent that we get, little bench, just some little idea that somebody's camping here. But what I like mostly about this place, again, people tend to build too big, but I'm really happy with how this one has kind of stuck to a nice scale. You have this huge plot, but the parts that they use as being functional, functional where someone would live or something, it seems the right size. I will say that I hunted and hunted and hunted, twirled my camera around, spent a long amount of time trying to see if there was actual accessible hatch house here, and I could not find it. If someone knows that it is there, you'll have to tell me the secret of how to get to it because I just could not get a hold of it. But as you can see, this is kind of like a frozen, I don't know if it's like a fin or just kind of a patch of ground or what. But they're using frozen lakes. They've really taken the time to add in a lot of grass patches, little weed patches. and the variety of different flowers and plants. You've got the brambles, the willows, even dead trees. They've got a few scattered stones here and there. And just to kind of make it look very wintry, very cold, just kind of dead. Oh, my stomach's starting to growl now. I don't think you can go off in there. It's kind of blocked off. But you got this raised little area, and it's kind of like, I call it like a little camp. Probably going at it the wrong way, but it's like where they would come. This is where they land. Maybe this is where their lookout is for incoming dangers or something. But I like how they're using a combination of things here to kind of build this little plateau. I think that's an exile thing. I don't even know what that is. I know it's something, but I don't know what it is. This is one of the Dominion transporter ships, I think. Ramshackle fencing, just one piece, but they found a use for it. Again, just one piece, but this is a way to kind of use those little single items that you have. But look at all the grass that they've taken the time to patch in. Because, they're using the snow ground, but they've planted in a lot of things themselves. A few pine trees, some of the flower bits, that kind of thing. I'm just ignoring the main part here. For now, we're just going around the edge. Again, frozen lakes, snow-covered stones, regular stones. Let me slow that down a little bit. Yeah, it could be, but there's an actual, I'll show you here shortly why I'm sure there is one. I just can't figure out how to get to it. This is like there's a track, a little path, leads to this little, you would presume like maybe a tunnel to some other zone, but they've had a bit of an avalanche, so now there's just rocks here. If you're wondering what stones are, that's the bottom of the makeshift bulletin board. I've used it for a lot of paths on some of my builds, so I recognize it. But it looks just like a pile of, rock rubble. Icicles on there. This part here is just a hover park piece. I love the piping though. It's a clever use of the rain gutters. And they've just basically they have it raised on these chain link fences. And every now and then they've got it bracketed with tua pillars, little supports. But the majority of it is just rain gutters. And that's what these pipes are. I thought it was a very clever idea because, someone that's working on some kind of a chemical plant or a laboratory and they are needing a lot of pipes and don't want to always resort to using the tubes that we have and they want a lot of little bracketry going on, this is a real good item to use. And here they've got it fixed off a bigger pipe with the little Granok topper on it. Notice something over here. I'm going to just take a closer look. Okay, just some mushrooms I saw from a distance. But I really like the idea of this little piping system that they've got going on. Just even here, this little junction here, the care and taken in how it's positioned, how they join it up, and then it goes directly into the rock. And there's that handy dandy Red Moon vent, and they've got a little piece of a pipe over here doing the same thing. Excuse me. So, if You start off, let's see, let me find the path here. You get onto the path. You see that it's just Draken floors. So it's a stony little path. This almost looks like some kind of like a airport strip with these little lamps. I don't know what those are exactly. I don't know if those are just the exile fence posts, or if it's one of those new ship parts from the space chase stuff. But it does, if you're looking for like a landing strip for an airplane or something, those would work really nice. Do that. But here's the little outpost, what I call it. I love just the construction of the buildings themselves, the size of the buildings. Everything feels, at least even, specifically maybe for my character size, everything feels very believable as far as the scaling. So here we have some strange little tank combinations. You got this wall that's broken down, so that's another way of getting in if you come the other direction. This here, if I can show it better, they've got it joined with the tank here, the combination of a bookcase and a Chua desk, I think. Just kind of joining it all together. Yeah, some of these stones, these really big ones, the camera, it's not a camera trick per se, but they don't have collision to them, so the camera will go right through them. It's one of the reasons why I don't like using them. The vents, those are from the new space chase, I'm pretty sure, but the smoke effect is from the blue flare, for those that aren't familiar with that. Again, they're using those gutters for that piping to kind of show that's a all connected, same way here, using those gutters. It's a really nifty looking way of building the pipes. So here you have some of their storage. This is like where they keep a lot of their boxes and stuff. I got some storage crates. This one, it looks like where they're loading it, and it kind of like botched up a little bit, so it's all kind of and not in a good way. If you're wondering what the little effects here are, the little wispy things, that's those buoyant blue crystals. It's just sunk down so that all you see is the animation. Let's go to this building first. This one has just got a sheet, using the sheet from the clothes as the little door cover. Mostly exile walls, sleeping bags, just your bare minimum. Because it's an outpost, it's not like they're really going to be high tech living here. The upstairs. This almost looks like a where someone would come with some guns to be able to shoot anybody, intruders or something. And then you got this nice large balcony. You zoom out, you can get a better look at the roofing. This triangle piece is the floor, and then the curved walls to make that nice little. Get my camera to work. Come on, you silly thing. There we go. To make that little pattern for the house. It's not perfect, but I like how it is. It's different. It's different than just having the flat or the pyramid, the pointed roof. I like the variety that it gives. And then in here you have your little meeting room, staging room, planning room. See, he's got his gun. I think it's like an outpost, kind of like where they're guard the place. Excuse me. Notice they're using the windows upside down. Most people will have them with the curved side up, but I think they wanted it to be flat along the roof and worked it that way. Again, mostly exile walls, but here they've got the Draken ones. People that love to use that as the dirt. Now, the last time I was here, this was boarded up. So I guess this means with it unboarded that they're done with it. But this is more like the little lab space. So here you have the little office upstairs. And then down here, they have this little, I don't know what this is supposed to be like. Acts like it's overgrown, this little power source or whatever it is. But that's like a technophage tube thing, and then it's got some mines, some two mines sandwiched on top. This part here is just two of pillars and two of floors kind of stuck together. The grating is the marauder netting, net shelves or whatever. Again, I don't know what this is supposed to be. Maybe this is where they process whatever they're pulling out of the pipes. But they've went through a lot of trouble of combining a lot of pieces to make this look the way it is. I don't know if it's, it resembles something actual. But like these are benches, the Dominion benches. That's I think it's a Dominion cannon. The ergonomics keyboard, the body scanner. This is one of the blue light lounge tables. And this looks like layered something, but it might just be part of the cannon. I can't tell. But I have absolutely no idea what it's supposed to represent. Here is a look from the inside of that bit that was kind of like botched up. So it looks like they used to have a ramp that you would send in the packages, and then it kind of got broken. Notice the skylight. It's just curved glass. Make that little skylight design. Now you can get to the underground from here, or you can just go here, or you can go down here. I think this was supposed to be maybe representative of an elevator shaft of some sort. And when you come down here, you see this is like that's where the conveyor belt is for all these bits. What they're processing, I have no idea, but something's like you open the hatch and it goes down the conveyor belt and into the hatch. I at first assumed that this is where the actual hatch house would be, but then it might also be under this mess. But I have been all over this thing and have not found where I can get the little. I get the activate button to pop up because there's some little interactables here already, but I haven't found one where it popped open the door button. So I don't know. I mean, if you look at the map, we're pretty much smack in the middle, so it should be around here somewhere, but I just don't. I don't see it. So I presume it's around in here somewhere because we kind of go under the main part of the building, even though maybe the rest of the plot is all raised with the snowy hills. This part is actually down below that level, and I don't know. But not only can you access this room from above through the various little openings that there are, like here. And over here. You can also access it from the outside by going through, where is it? The purple bush. Where the pipe is here. You just go through the bush and you find a tunnel. And out you come right here. Most people wouldn't notice this coming around. You just see all these rocks and they just look right past it, but that's where you can sneak in from the backside. So, well, not like a super outlandish plot. Yeah, maintenance in 30 minutes. I really like the concept of it and a lot of the tricks they use, especially like the pipes and some of the roofing of the houses and just the way they followed through with their plot theme as far as the frozen ground and everything. I think they did a really good job on that. So, again, it's not always you don't have to have this wow factor when you come in. Just little details really catches my eye a lot. So, even though this build may not be as complex as some of the other ones we've visited, I still like the effort that was put into it. So yeah, that's today's show, you guys. I hope you've enjoyed all of these homes. I hope you've enjoyed all of the old homes that we visited in the past. Just a reminder, we are fast approaching our 50th House Tours episode. I got a little thread in the official forums about it. It's in the housing section. I'm asking my viewers to submit their favorites from over the last year, because what the idea is we will be retouring some of these favorites on our 50th House Tours episode, just to kind of pay extra homage to those that have inspired us the most, those that have the most memorable. I mean, there's some plots you go to and they always come to mind when someone says, spaceship or like a game theme or something like some of the World of Warcraft ones we've come to visit, or those that really have some new and clever concepts like the ones that look like they're totally floating in the sky, or those that have underwater builds, something that you don't see every day. So I'm asking my viewers to come up with a list. I'm not saying you can only list one or only list five, just whatever your favorites are. Let me know. You can either post them directly there in the thread, you can PM me, you can tweet me, you can Twitch me, however you want to get in contact with me, and it's most convenient for you, do so. Let me know what your favorites are. There's, I'm afraid, tons of videos to go through if you haven't been watching all this time. But they're archived, they're available both on the Twitch channel or YouTube, whichever one works for you. And just take the time to go through them and see which ones you think you want to suggest or nominate or whatever you want to call it. And from those, I will pick a good many or as many as I can fit in to tour while we hang out together on that special day. I originally was going to say that it was going to be like a 3-hour kind of thing, but depending on how many people are around, how many homes we decide to have on our list of favorites and everything, it could run longer, it could be shorter. If nobody shows up, then it's going to be like the shortest episode ever, but I'm hoping that won't be the case. But the idea is we'll be touring, and while we're touring, we will be giving away special gifts. Speaking of which, I'm thinking Friday I'm going to do some testing on that giveaway system. So if those of you that normally hang out with me know that you could be there for Friday, that would be grand, because the more I have around to kind of test it with, I think the better. If that's not a good day for most of you guys, let me know and I'll set it up for a different day, but I think I'm going to aim for Friday for that. There is a small chance I won't be here tomorrow. I may have other plans that come up that kind of conflict with my timing, but for sure I'm going to try and be here Friday. And I'm thinking we're going to run our first little test of how that giveaway system goes, the little program that I've got set up for it. Because I'd just like to make sure we iron out all those bugs before the actual show so we don't have any problems during the broadcast. Yeah, I'm not really going into specifics about what all is going to be available prize-wise. I just will say that I am, or I have been in contact with Carbine, and they have said that they will provide some stuff, but as yet that has not happened. It is still a few weeks away, so I'm got my fingers crossed that they're just waiting until a little bit before. But I don't really want to. I've already bugged them a couple of times about it. I don't want to do it again. So I'm just kind of going on blind faith that they'll remember about it. And so hopefully I'll have some extra good things to give away to those that attend. But definitely I want some suggestions from you guys over your past favorites. Even if it's your own, if that happens to be your favorite, more power to you. But definitely let me know what those are, and I can start compiling a list of possibles for that special day. As well, reminder, this evening, our time, CET time, they are conducting a PTR focus test for Arctera. I think it's just a couple of hours that they're doing it. It's mainly to get into the 20-man content, but I presume anyone that logs in during that time frame will get credit. But if you do, you will be getting a special exclusive title called Art Tester. And so if you're a collector of titles and you want something a little unique that not everybody's going to have, and you can make it, that is this evening. It's starts at 10:30 a.m. PDT, which is 6:30 p.m. CET. So for those of you in my neck of the woods, it'll be this evening. Also, just another reminder that those of you that are on NA side that don't have access to Jabbit and have been wondering about getting access to the Easter egg hunt plot, Greenleaf Acres on my alt Celery Greenleaf, you will be happy to know that that has safely copied over to the PTR. So it is now available for you guys if you want to take a look, try your hand at hunting those eggs. I did link it in my tweet, but there is a thread in the forums in the housing sub forum all about it. It will tell you specifically, there's a little snapshot of all of the eggs, the different types that you would need to be looking for. There are 31 hidden eggs, and yeah, just try your luck at trying to find them all. I didn't, get super clever, but for some, I think they might find it a little tricky to find them all. Oh, well, I'm sorry to hear that, Bones. I'm hoping I will remember. I tend to kind of forget to check on that kind of stuff later in the evening, so I'll have to write myself a note. Well, soccer, a lot of people don't want to spoil things for themselves. Normally, I just go in mostly to check out some of the new housing items because sometimes knowing in advance what's coming, you can kind of plan ahead of what you might want to use them for. But beyond that, I don't like go questing or anything. I just kind of prefer to kind of keep that for when the actual content comes out, then it's, still fresh and new to me. 19 or 20 eggs out of 31. That's not too bad. One of my guildmates, I think the least one was 17, I think is how many she found. We had one, he found 30. He thought he had found 31, but then when he added up all his screenshots, he can only confirm 30. So I think he was kicking himself once he found out that there were actually 31. I think the one, well, I'm not going to say which one he missed, but he had one nearby that he got, and he's probably going, I had it, but I was so close. But yeah. So I think that's all the reminders. Again, thank you guys for joining. I appreciate the chatter, the conversations, the company. I definitely appreciate all of the tweets, the retweets, the follows, just the general support. It makes me feel like, doing this isn't too dorky or useless, that people enjoy seeing this stuff and us talking about it and kind of working out what is being used and how and all that kind of stuff. It's always a fun challenge for me. But yeah, I hope you guys have a good day. Try not to come down with any of my cooties. Hopefully, I didn't transmit them through the stream. Hopefully, I don't get any worse than I am right now. I feel mostly just a little congested, and throat thing is really bugging me. But my desk is like a deconstructed pharmacy. I've got all kinds of cough drops and pills and cough syrup and all sorts of things. So hopefully I will drug up and be A-okay from here on. Well, see, Ducky, that's where you got to kind of pay attention. Well, yeah, you have to get into that stuff, soccer. Thank you, Maddie. I appreciate it. So yeah, you guys have a good day. Again, maintenance is incoming, so be prepared for that. I think it's an extended one, like 3 or 4 hours or something. It's like hardware maintenance, so you're gonna have to find yourself something else to tinker with until then. And of course, PTR this evening for those that can or want to make it. But I'm not gonna be 100% on tomorrow. Just keep an eye out for the tweet. I will definitely tweet either way. Whether I'm gonna show up or not, so that you guys aren't just waiting around all day. But definitely Friday. If you can make it here Friday, I would really appreciate it because I would love to test the little giveaway program thing. In the meantime, have a good day. Have a good rest of the week. If I don't see you till later, stay safe and I'll see you next time. Bye bye.